IPM for cotton aphid is really a multifaceted approach. And the first thing is to think about farm hygiene. The cotton aphid in Australia doesn't have a diapause. If you have weeds scattered around the farm, you're providing a host there for them to survive through winter. Some of those hosts, things like cotton ratoons or volunteers, bladderkepnia and marshmallow, are also potentially hosts for cotton bunchy top disease. The second component of aphid IPM is good monitoring early in the season so you know what's entering the crop. Also, look out for the beneficials that are going to help manage those aphids for you. They're acting effectively. They'll basically hold the population. The minute you suppress natural enemies, aphid populations can boom quite quickly. A critical feature of managing aphids is to know what the population's doing. So you really need to be able to track the population over time, because that'll tell you if the beneficial complex is having an impact. When you are monitoring aphids, select a plant at random in the field. You count down 1, 2, 3, leaf 4 or leaf 5 below the terminal, and then you can remove that leaf and then score it on the 1-5 system for aphid abundance. The idea of the 1-5 system is where you're able to rank leaves as a 1, which is very low numbers of aphids, up to a 5, which is very high numbers of aphids. So we know a bit more information about the aphid population than just scoring the presence or absence. Record the score for each leaf and work out an average score for that check. You can then use a lookup chart in the Cotton Pest Management Guide to convert the sample score for the last check and the sample score for this check into a cumulative score, and then you can look up the potential yield loss if that population continues. And that provides you with a good basis for deciding whether the aphid population needs control for yield loss. Later on, you'll be making a separate decision based on the presence of honeydew on the bowls. If you need to make a control decision, it's important to think about what option you use for aphids, because they've been documented to have developed resistance to quite a few different products. The Cotton Pest Management Guide has information about the current resistance status, and that can help guide your product choice. So the threshold approach takes into account the fact that aphid populations can start to build in the crop at different times, and they can have different rates of increase. So if you take the sampling information that you've collected and link that with the threshold information in the Cotton Pest Management Guide, that gives you a very good capacity to make a projection of future yield loss.